अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सिक्स्थ लेक्चर ऑफ योर इंग्लिश क्लास. इफ़ यू रिमेंबर द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कॉमन नाउन एंड प्रॉपर नाउन. वी डिस्कस्ड द नाउन इज़ द नेम ऑफ अ नाउन, कैन बी एनी थिंग, पर्सन, प्लेस और यू नो एनी आइडिया. सो वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट कॉमन नाउन एंड प्रॉपर नाउन. दैट कॉमन नाउन इट स्टार्ट्स विद It is the name. It is not the name of a specific person or a place or a thing or idea. Proper noun is the name for a specific person, place or an idea. So that's the difference. And a proper noun always starts with a capital letter. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about pronouns. So what comes to your mind when I say the word pronoun? So what do you understand by pronoun? Okay. So let's discuss this. A pronoun is a word that takes place of a noun. Sometimes in a sentence, we don't use nouns. We use pronouns. We don't use specific names of a thing or a person or a place. We use a pronoun instead of it. We use other words instead of a noun. And those words are called pronouns. So sometimes we use words that instead of nouns, and these words are called pronouns. A pronoun is a word that takes the place of a noun. So for example, I, me, my, you, your, he, she, it, us, we, they, them, his, her, their, mine, our, myself, himself, herself, itself, yourself, themselves, ourselves, who, whose, whom, anybody, anyone, everybody, nobody, somebody, somebody, someone, somebody. So these are all pronouns. There are sentences when you say that, there are times when you write the sentence and you don't write about a boy or a girl. You say I, me, you, they, or we. You write he, she. So those are pronouns, because those are words which are used instead of nouns. So these are some of examples of pronouns, and you should know them. You should know that these are called pronouns. These are not nouns, these are pronouns. And these are used in place of nouns. Okay, for example, a pronoun is a word that takes the place of a noun. Instead of saying Erin likes to eat, you could say she likes to eat. So she is placed instead of Erin. So this is a pronoun. So sometimes you say that when somebody asks you a question, is your father well? Yeah, you would say yes, he is well. So you have replaced father with he. So you have changed the noun with a pronoun. So similarly in this sentence, Erin likes to eat. So you could also say that she likes to eat. So it depends on the situation and the structure of the sentence. What is the pronoun in the following sentence? Okay, now just look at the sentence and tell me which is the pronoun in the sentence. I sing loudly in the shower. So what is the pronoun in the sentence? Is it sing? Is it loudly? Is it I? Is it shower? What do you think is the pronoun in this sentence? Which word is replaced by the noun? Which replaced by the noun? So just guess it and just say it loudly. Okay, now I'll tell you the answer. The answer is I. Okay, so the answer is I. I is the pronoun because it takes place of a noun. I replaces someone more specific like girl, boy, Bob or Mrs. Ryan. So I, when you talk about I, you say about somebody is talking about myself, self. So, and you're talking about a specific girl, boy or somebody. So that's a pronoun. So pronouns are these words which are placed instead of nouns, and you should remember pronouns. Okay, now let's talk about adjective. What is an adjective? An adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. It tells what kind of, how many or which one. So adjective basically answers three questions. It tells more about the noun. When in a sentence, if a word is described, if a word describes the noun, then that's a adjective. Adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. It tells what kind of, how many are there or which one. It answers these kind of questions. Like if there is a shirt, how many shirts are there? in the word which will tell us that there are four shirts, five shirts, then that will be an adjective. And if the color of those, all the colors in the world are noun, adjectives. So you should remember that all the colors, because they define a thing, they are adjectives. Okay, and the taste of it and everything that describes the noun, any word that describes a noun or a pronoun is called adjective. Okay, so an adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. It tells us what kind of, how many, or which one. So you have to remember that adjective describes a noun and tell us about more about the noun. So it answers questions like these, that how many things are there, which ones, how, what color is there, what what kind of structure do they have, or how many are there. So it answers certain these kind of questions. For example, there's a question here. Erin has blonde hair. So what is the noun in the sentence? Erin. And Erin has what? Hair. Hair is also a noun. So what kind of hair Erin has? She has blonde hair. It is describing more about the noun, because hair is a noun and we are, this is the hair is the noun, and this word blonde is telling more about, it tells us more about what kind of hair she has. She has blonde hair. So this tells us more about noun. So for example, I'd say that the color of the chair is yellow. So what is the noun in this the adjective in this sentence? Yellow. And what is a noun? Chair. So because the chair noun, the color yellow is defined by yellow describes the chair, that the color of the chair is yellow. So what kind of thing is it? It is it's yellow. So the any word that is describing the noun or pronoun is called adjective. So for example, in this sentence, what is the adjective? It is blonde. Okay. So yes, Erin's hair, great work. So I've already told you that adjective, so you can learn more about adjective. So I'm going to now let's also read about the third one, verb. A verb is the action of the sentence. It shows what someone or something is doing. So any word that describes action, what kind of work is being done, how the work is being, what kind of work is done, any action that is being done in a sentence is called a verb. So verb is an action verb. It describes actions of all types. For example, run, paint, read, all these are actions. Somebody's using their muscles, using their body to do something. So these are verbs. So it is a kind of action. You have to move in a verb. Okay, so it is an action verb. Running, jumping, painting, reading, writing, moving, walking, sitting, standing, seeing. And remember, any word that ends with ing is a word. Okay, that's a tip, that any word that is ends with an ing is called a verb. So verbs like, okay, she is reading a book, so reading is the verb, ing, because it's telling us some action. She's eating something, she's dancing, she's moving, she's walking, she's panting, painting, she's fainting, she's falling, she's tripping, she's slipping, she's dripping, she's dripping, the water is dripping. So all these are verbs, because they are telling us about some action. Okay, a verb is the word action of the sentence. What is the subject doing? In the example, I have already told you that a subject in a sentence means that what the subject sentence is talking about. The main thing in the sentence is called the subject. The main person, place, or a thing about which the sentence is telling us some information is the subject of the sentence. Means that, for example, if you are studying English, so English is the subject. So, and if you open the book of English, everything will be about English language or English, English. So similarly, if you open mathematics book, it will be all mathematics. So it is the subject of the sentence, because everything is the verb, is the subject. So Erin is the basically subject, what the sentence is talking about. So Erin is running the 5k. What is Erin doing? What is the question? What is Erin doing? Erin is running the 5k. So what is the noun in the sentence? Erin. This is the subject of the sentence. So what is he doing? He is running the 5k. Okay, he is running the 5k. So running would be the verb, because it is telling us about action. What is he doing? He's running. So verb basically answers the questions running. So verb basically answers the question, what is someone doing? It tells us about the action of the sentence. All right. So for example, I say that Elena is sitting on the couch. So Elena, what is Elena doing? She's sitting. Who is sitting on the couch? Elena. So Elena is the subject, Elena is the noun, and Elena is sitting on the couch. What is he doing? She's sitting. This is an action. So sitting would be the verb. Okay, students. So today we have talked about pronouns, adjectives, and verbs. So what are pronouns? Pronouns are words that are used in place of nouns. And for example, he, she, it, they, we, us, themselves, nobody, somebody. These are pronouns. These are words that are placed in, that are used instead of a noun. So these are pronouns. Then we have talked about adjective. What is an adjective? An adjective is a word that describes a noun. An adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. It tells us more about the noun. For example, all the colors in the world are adjective. Yellow, pink, green, lilac, purple, orange, saffron. All these colors are adjectives. And the third one would be verb. Verb is a word that tells us about the action in the sentence. So what the subject is doing in the sentence is called the verb. So if he's jumping, running, swimming, cycling, jogging, walking, reading, writing, sitting, dancing, whatever. So that's a verb. Okay. So we have talked about the parts of speech that are pronouns, verbs, and adjectives. So I hope that you have understood. If you haven't understood anything, then you should ask me, and I'm going to see you in the next lecture. So till then, take care and Allah Hafiz.